DJI Mini 3 First Use. Unboxing. Open the box and remove DJI Mini 3 and its accessories. Using DJI RC N1 for the first time. Download and install the DJI Fly app on your smartphone. Take out the control sticks from the storage slots at the bottom of the remote controller. Install the control sticks. Extend the mobile device clamp. And the connector on the right with a remote controller icon is used to connect the remote controller. And the connector on the left is used to connect your smartphone. Take out the connector from the left and unwind it to the right. Place your smartphone inside the clamp with the charging port on the right side. Tighten the clamp, and then connect the remote controller cable to your smartphone. Using DJI RC for the first time. Press the remote controller power button once and then again and hold for about 2 seconds to power on or off the remote controller. Select the language. Select the country and region, and then connect to the Wi-Fi network. Select the time zone, date, and time. Log into your DJI account. Tap Activate. Swipe left or right on the edge of the screen to return to the home screen. It is recommended to insert an SD card when using DJI RC. Preparing the aircraft. When using the battery for the first time, connect the USB-C port at the rear of the aircraft directly to the battery charger. If the battery level is at approximately 50% or below, it is recommended to charge the battery to 75% or above first to ensure enough power for activation and firmware update. Press the aircraft power button once and then again and hold for about 2 seconds to power on or off the aircraft. Activating and updating. Launch DJI Fly and log in. Follow the app's instructions to complete the activation process. If you have purchased or intend to purchase DJI Care Refresh, please finish the purchase and binding within 48 hours of activating the aircraft. If a firmware update is available, a prompt will appear in the upper left corner of the screen. Tap it to enter the update screen. Tap Update to update the aircraft and remote controller to the latest firmware version. During the update, do not power off the device or exit the app. After the update is completed, the aircraft and remote controller will remain powered off. Preparing for flight. Remove the storage cover, unfold the aircraft arms, and make sure that the propellers are properly installed. Check if the SD card has been inserted. Make sure that the battery is securely installed. Place the aircraft on level ground with the rear facing you. Launch DJI Fly and enter "Go Fly." Before takeoff, set the remote controller in the normal mode. Tap Safety and set the RTH height higher than the tallest building or nearby object. Flying basics. Check the app flight interface and make sure that the aircraft has automatically refreshed the home point. Confirm that there are no abnormal reminders and the GPS signal is good. Tap the takeoff icon on the left, and then press and hold the prompt icon to enable auto takeoff. After takeoff, the icon will change to auto landing. Tap and hold the pop-up window to make the aircraft land automatically. Pull both control sticks all the way to the bottom of the controller, and then push them inwards or outwards. When the propellers start to rotate, gently push the throttle stick up to take off. The left control stick is for adjusting the aircraft's altitude and orientation. The right control stick allows the aircraft to move forward, backward, and to the left and right. After you start the motors, if the aircraft has not taken off, pull down the left control stick to stop the motors. If the aircraft has taken off, pull down the left control stick to land. Pressing the flight pause button once can make the aircraft brake and hover in place. You can view the flight distance, flight altitude, and speed in the bottom left corner of the app. Keep the remote controller antenna facing the aircraft during flight for optimal transmission. When the aircraft enters attitude mode, land in a safe location as soon as possible to avoid accidents. Taking photos and videos. Press halfway to activate autofocus. Press all the way down once to take a photo. Press to start recording. Press again to stop recording. You can also adjust the gimbal pitch and control the camera by using the gimbal dial on the left side of the remote controller. You can use the dial on the right side of the remote controller to adjust the camera zoom in video mode. Tap the portrait button on the app interface to enter portrait mode. Enter the camera parameter setting in the bottom right corner of the DJI Fly app to adjust other camera parameters. Tap the playback icon in the bottom right corner of the screen to view and download your footage. Smart RTH. There are two methods to perform Smart RTH. Method 1, tap the RTH icon on the left side of the screen and hold. Method 2, press and hold the RTH button on the remote controller. The aircraft will also perform Smart RTH or land in the following situations. When the aircraft determines that the current battery level is only sufficient for performing RTH, a prompt will appear on the DJI Fly app confirming whether to initiate RTH. When the current battery level is only sufficient for landing, the aircraft will initiate forced landing. The pilot can slow down the landing speed by pushing the throttle stick upward and moving the aircraft horizontally. When the aircraft is disconnected from the remote controller, the aircraft will perform Smart RTH by default. Safety precautions. Before takeoff, check if the flight environment meets all requirements. And set the RTH altitude. Check that the propellers are undamaged and properly installed. Check that the battery is securely installed. Replacing the propellers. DJI Mini 3 has two different types of motors, AB, and propellers, AB, that pair up. Any propeller that is deformed, corroded, or has loose screws should be replaced. When replacing a propeller, use the Phillips screwdriver and screws provided in the box. Storage. Fold the aircraft arms and attach the storage cover. Stow the front arm propellers at the center of the aircraft's bottom. Avoid applying excessive force on the propellers during storage. Linking. The remote controller is already linked to the aircraft when purchased together as a combo. Tap linking guide in the bottom right corner of the DJI Fly app and follow the instructions to link the aircraft and remote controller. The remote controller is ready for linking when it beeps and its battery level LEDs blink. Press and hold the aircraft power button for about 4 seconds and release it after hearing an indicator tone. When the aircraft battery level LEDs blink, the linking process has begun. Once linking is successful, the remote controller stops beeping, the aircraft and remote controller battery level LEDs turn solid. And the app displays the video transmission screen. Quick transfer. Power on the aircraft. Press the power button 3 times, the aircraft will enter quick transfer mode. After a successful connection, the aircraft status indicator turns from solid green to blinking blue. Enable Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on your mobile device. Launch the DJI Fly app, and the system will give you a message prompting you to connect the aircraft. Tap to enter. Tap to join the aircraft Wi-Fi. After a successful connection, access the aircraft album and select shots to download at high speed. Power on the aircraft. Enable Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on your mobile device. Tap to enter playback in the DJI Fly app. Tap the quick transfer icon in the upper right corner of the app. Tap to switch to quick transfer mode. Tap to join the aircraft Wi-Fi. Once switching is complete, you can enter quick transfer mode and select shots to download at high speed.